This is likely the most popular drug in America. What is it? Caffeine is in a lot of stuff, but most of it in our sodas and energy drinks is synthetic, meaning it's not from a natural source. How did this happen? And what else don't we know about this drug? In the early days, Coca-Cola was powered less from cocaine and more from powdered caffeine taken from imported tea. Americans, of course, fell in love with the beverage. But then, World War II hit.
Caffeine manufacturers are literally scraping the bin as their supplies of caffeine-bearing raw materials are about to reach the vanishing point.
One company, though, had a plan. We wouldn't need the foreign stuff if they could engineer caffeine entirely from scratch. Raw, powdered caffeine could be made right here at home. Monsanto's product was chemically identical to the natural stuff, and more importantly, it was cheaper. Today, making caffeine is a massive global industry. Some of what we get is natural, but most of it is synthetic, made in India and China. But natural or synthetic, pure caffeine's a powerful drug. A tiny amount goes a long way. One heaping tablespoon can kill.
That's what happened when this 18-year-old Ohio high school senior used powdered caffeine. He died just before graduation.
The FDA says to avoid these powders, but it hasn't banned its sales. Anyone can buy some online, no questions asked. See, the way America regulates caffeine, it's kind of a mess. For instance, when caffeine is mixed into soda or energy drinks, it's called a food additive. But pressed into pills, caffeine is regulated like a pharmaceutical. In energy shots and powders, caffeine is treated like a dietary supplement, which the FDA mostly ignores. It's a regulatory circus with no ringmaster. Turns out, there's no federal limit for how much caffeine can be added to foods. Products don't even have to list how much caffeine they contain. What's more, foreign caffeine factories are almost never inspected. One of the few times they were, the FDA found some pretty filthy conditions. We're still learning how caffeine reacts with alcohol and other drugs. Trips to the ER involving caffeine-laced energy drinks have doubled in just a few years. The explosion of caffeinated products and how they're marketed makes you wonder, how much can we take before we crash?